counting down now to first pitch in South Florida. Interleague Baseball, next. Now from the sunshine state of Florida, we're under the lights at the beautiful new Marlins Park. Tonight, the start of a three-game interleague series between the Baltimore Orioles and the East-leading Miami Marlins. With that, we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. Matt Vaskirjian here with you. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, a good matchup on the mound here in this opener.
Well, you see here, here's a couple of guys that have gotten off to really good starts so far number-wise. Both pitching with a lot of confidence right now, and I expect their good starts to continue, and I think this could be a low-scoring game.
All right, Steve, EK will join us in a moment, but before he does, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the Baltimore Orioles, as Buck Showalter's crew will line up like this. And look there at the starting pitcher charged with facing these guys as his numbers are on your screen. And in the field, the Marlins will align themselves like this. David Lowe will move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight. The game's opening pitch is taken for ball one as we get started here tonight right on time at 7:10. EK, let's take a look at our homestanding nine as they enter play here this evening. They come in riding a five-game winning streak, and they've really got things clicking.
And something's going to have to give here in game one because both of these teams come in riding winning streaks. They've played some of their best baseball this season, so this is set up to be an exciting series.
Yeah, an easy fly ball there to start the ball game.
One of the big keys for them in this one is going to be keeping that leadoff man off base.
Off to a good start here.
Manny Machado will stand in now. He drove in two of their three runs in that ball game yesterday. Now the first pitch. And he gives this one a pretty good ride down the left field line. And this is called a foul ball. Maybe by a matter of inches that time. And now we're going to get a stoppage here as the four umpires will gather together near third base to discuss whether or not that was really a foul ball. And remember now, if there's any uncertainty, the umpires can go inside to get a look at the video feed from headquarters in New York. And I believe that's exactly what they're going to do. We'll give you a look at this from our own cameras and let you make the call for yourself. Okay, the umpires have emerged from the dugout with the ruling. And it is going to remain a foul ball. So they had it right the first time. But if there's any doubt, go inside and get this thing right. Machado now on 0-1. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. On to first, and there were two down.
Batting third, center fielder number 10.
Adam Jones will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first. First offering on the way. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
The next pitch. Now a check swing, but it's strike one anyway, says the home plate umpire. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. And the throw forces him to lay out for that one, but he keeps a foot on the bag to record the out. 1-2-3 go the Orioles. Now the Marlins will see what they can do. No score. A look there at the starting lineup for the host Marlins. They'll match up against a guy who's made great strides the last few years, the 6'5" right-hander Chris Tillman. And defensively, the Orioles look like this. Gordon will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
Leading off for the Marlins, second baseman, D. Gordon.
First pitch of the inning here is wrapped right back from where it came, and that'll get into center field for a leadoff single.
Well, things are looking up for these guys to start the ball game. They get a 1-2-3 top half. And then now, leadoff single here in the home half, off to a great start.
Christian Yelich will get his first opportunity now. He's got to be feeling pretty good about things recently, as you see his numbers over the course of the past 10 ball games. Here's the first offering. And they start him out away with a called strike. EK, you look at these Orioles as they begin play here tonight. They're on a nice little run, winners of four of their last five ball games.
And something's going to have to give here in game one, because both of these teams come in riding winning streaks. They've played some of their best baseball this season, so this is set up to be an exciting series.
It skips in and he's safe. Close play, but he's in there.
And this is one of those guys that can certainly be an X factor in this series. He sets a tone early here with a first inning steal of second base.
Ready now on 1-1. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2. Well, you see there on the graphic, he's into double digits now with his 10th swipe of the year. Tillman ready with a 1-2 over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Again, a 1-2. And this one's in the dirt. But fortunately here, no advance. Sets the 2-2 pitch. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, and no surprise, we talk about it all the time in the beginning of a ball game. Location is going to be a key. And here you can just see where this thing is. If he can continue spotting pitches there, he'll have a lot of success here tonight.
Giancarlo Stanton will dig in now. He had a couple of hits in yesterday's contest.
Let's get the runner across.
First pitch coming. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1.
You know, it's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
He's set, now the pitch. In there, and it's 0-2 now. Surprised at all that they're coming right after him this way?
A little bit. I like it. It's good for the game, but this is definitely a guy that can hurt you if you're not careful.
Foss, now the pitch. Ball and two strikes now to the 2014 All-Star.
And that's his strikeout pitch right there. You know, you'll see a lot of guys swing right over the top of that one. That's a great job there just to hold off.
The 1-2. Inside for a ball, so he misses with two straight here. It's back to 2-2.
You can see where they want to go to try and get him out. A lot of pitches in on the hands in this sequence. They don't want him to be able to extend.
Here comes a 2-2. And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down.
Well, that's a good confidence builder with a runner on base here in the first. This is definitely the man to worry about in this lineup. There's a little question about that, so he'll be fired up about that one.
Marcell Ozuna will stand in, and he's certainly a dangerous man up there, currently second in the National League in RBIs.
Let's go, Marlin!
Now here's the first pitch, and he takes ball one. And speaking of the NL RBI leaders, there they are on your screen. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. The 1-0 pitch. Lays off the fastball away, and it's 2-0.
This is a guy whose numbers are on the rise, and this is a big reason why. Two close pitches, two good takes, and now he's in a great hitter's count, 2-0.
Here comes the 2-0. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Yeah, he got his 2-0 fastball, but it wasn't in that one place, one spot that we always talk about. So that was a good idea to let that one go and wait for something else.
Tillman on 2-1, and this is on the ground toward the hole. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Second inning coming up here in South Florida with no score. Steve Pierce will dig in for the first time here, looking to change his fortunes a bit as he's seen that average dip these last four or so games. Here's the pitch. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Here's the 1-0. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. The 1-1. Now here's a ground ball that'll get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single.
Yeah, he hit a good pitch there. This thing's toward the outside part of the plate, but he stays with it all the way. Uses the big part of the field and gets himself a base hit.
Into the box, Caleb Joseph showing bunt here, but he takes ball one. Enters play here at 279. Three homers and six RBIs. The 1-0. Called strike at the knees. evens the count at 1-1.
All right, guys, let's do it. Come on.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. In there, 1-2 now.
Very patient here to start the at-bat. Maybe even a little too patient because now he's down 1-2.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going to get anything better than that to hit.
Here comes a 1-2. And he struck him out.
Well, this curveball, it just disappears. He thinks he's right on it at the plate. Look where it winds up. Completely out of the zone. That's what you want as a pitcher. You want hitters to chase pitches that aren't strikes.
Stepping in now, Ryan Flaherty, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He's ready now. The pitch off the plate. One ball, one strike. The 1-1 home. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Well, this is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count. And that alone can be beneficial to an offense.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. Over at the knees, and that's the second strike.
Now you got to beware of that sinker. I mean, he'd take a strikeout right now, but I think he still just wants this guy to hit the ball on the ground.
No score here as we play inning number two. Here he comes on 2-2. And this is fouled straight back. Here's the 2-2 offering. Swing, hard hit ball to second. Look at this. Solano for one. On to Morse at first. It's a double play, and the inning is over. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. More to come from Marlins Park right after this. Michael Morse will start things off in the bottom of the second.
First baseman, Michael Morse.
Now the first pitch. And that misses ball one. Here's a 1-0. First two pitches off the mark here. It's 2-0.
Two times here they've gone away. Both pretty easy takes. And as a hitter, now I'm thinking it might be time they try to bust something inside.
Here's the 2-0. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. And a good throw gets him one gone. Martin Prado will stand in now, 0-4 in that day game yesterday. First pitch coming. In there for strike one, 0-1. Pitch on the way. Now a swing and a bouncing ball toward the hole. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
some guys, you almost do them a favor if you pitch away from them. Here, he's just doing what he does best. Great balance here. Good swing path, and he drives it the other way.
Catcher Jared Saltalamacchia is in now as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. Batting average down in the low 210s. Four home runs and 11 RBIs. Comes set, now the pitch. And Saltalamacchia swings right through that one as he's in the hole now, down 0-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Bottom of the second here with no score. Here's the 1-2. Knuckle curve, and he can't ring him up as it goes to 2-2.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
Here now the 2-2. Now a chopper to first, might only get one. And he'll get the fielder's choice play at second, but that's all.
This is always a tough throw here for a first baseman coming off the bag. You gotta make sure that you don't just throw the ball right into the runner's back heading down to second base. Here he takes just a little extra time to make sure that he makes a good throw. And they're gonna settle for just one at second.
Donovan Solano will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And here's the first pitch. Change up, a little bit inside, 1-0. The 1-0. Not close, it's 2-0.
I think he's going out there right now just to remind his guy, hey, this is the number 8 hitter up there. No reason to work the edges. You just come right after him.
Two out with the man at first. Hitters count 2-0. And that's taken for a strike on the inside corner. 2-1. High strikes, probably not on the docket for places he wants to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's no secret. You've got to keep the ball down against a team like this. If you go up every once in a while with a fastball, you'll be fine. But you're not going to last too long if you make a habit of working up there with your secondary pitches.
At the knees for a called strike, and it's back to even at 2-2. 2-2. Oh, a good swing right there. This is banged into right, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. And with that, that'll push his hit streak to a modest 6 games. Jared Cozart will get a shot now with 2 on and 2 out here in inning number 2. Now here's the first pitch. Called a strike on the outer half, 0-1. From the belt, the pitch, ball one.
You get a good look right there. Already 33 pitches now through an inning and 2/3. That's an awfully high number this early.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Outside, 2-1. All the way here to start the at-bat.
And that's fine, but you can't be afraid to work inside. You can jam this guy. Get him to roll over something. You don't have to strike him out.
Here he comes on 2-1. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. Two-two pitch on the way. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three, as they'll need to throw to first here. And the throw is in time. It's a strikeout, and the play at first goes 2-3 for good measure as the inning is over. Marlins strand a pair. We'll move to the third with no score. Jonathan Schoop will stand in now, still struggling to get anything going offensively.
Jonathan Schoop.
First pitch to him. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Now here's the pitch. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. One on the way. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. A 2-1 offering. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Well, this is a good job to work the count from 0-1 to 3-1. And now he's really in the driver's seat to see a fastball.
Now the 3-1 home. Swing, strike two.
That's a really good 12-6 curveball there. And he'll throw that on any count, even when he's behind, because he has such confidence in that pitch.
Here's the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and lifted in the air to left. One away here to begin the third. J.P. Arencibia will be the batter. Here's the first offering. Started to go around there, but he holds up ball one.
He just about went around. He was lucky to put on the brakes when he did.
Third inning, no score to this point.
Let's go.
1-0 on the way. Swing and a ground ball towards the hole. In time to first, and there are two away. Chris Tillman will step in now. Here's the first pitch to him. There's the cut fastball, but it's low, 1-0. Now the 1-0. Fouled straight back. Two out, nobody on. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Grounded foul toward the coaching box at third. One, two. Slice down the line at first, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for the Orioles. Home half of the third coming up, no score. D. Gordon makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three.
Second baseman.
Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Bonnie jolts this half inning to attention as the first pitch is hit into right field for a leadoff single.
Well, you talk about an offseason pickup that changes the entire dynamic of your ball club. The Marlins had plenty of those in the winter, but none more dramatic than getting Gordon to lead off and play second base for this club. He always has the ability to turn a single into maybe a double or even a triple with that speed he's got. So we'll see if he's going to be on the move right here.
In is Christian Yelich. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. One oh pitch now, and it's a called strike to even the count at one. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the runner on first so he doesn't steal at all.
Now the 1-1. Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field, and that'll get down out there for extra bases.
Well, they've been held off the scoreboard so far, but they are definitely knocking on the door now. Get the leadoff single followed by a double here, and they're in a good position to break through, maybe even with a big inning.
Giancarlo Stanton now. As he swings and hits this one foul off to the right and out of play.
Let's go, Marlins!
He's set, now the pitch. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. Runners at second and third here, nobody out. He waits, now the pitch. Hit hard but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. Another 0-2 coming. Changes up on him if that's in the dirt for a ball.
And even on 1-2 now, you've got to expand the strike zone a little up there. You can't go down looking here. You've got to put this ball in play.
Big pitch here, 1-2. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here.
And again, they try to take him down in the strike zone just to see if he'll go after that pitch below the knees. But with two strikes, he's been able to lay off that thing now twice in a row.
Now the 2-2 pitch. Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around. The 2-2 one more time, and a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. EK, where are you going now on 3-2?
I still got to work a corner. Not just going to throw it right down the middle and grab a strike. Can't be a giveaway pitch.
Full count offering on its way. In the air to straightaway center field. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And he will score on the sacrifice fly as he's in with our first tally of the ball game.
That's all he's hoping to do right here. Just get that thing airborne and get that first run of the game home. He does his job, picks up the RBI.
Marcell Ozuna will stand in, looking to make this a 2-0 game if he can perhaps get a ball airborne. First pitch on the way. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one. Any thought to bringing the infield in here with one away?
Still a little early in my book. A run you can live with. What you don't want to do is let this snowball into a big inning.
Come set, now the pitch. And this one gets away. That could be a run. Throw to the plate, and they're not going to get him as he's in there to score.
That's a nice job that time down there at third. He read that right away. He's able to come in and score that time on the wild pitch to the backstop.
1-1 pitch on the way. There's a foul ball off to the right side, and that'll move the count to 1-2. The right-hander deals on 1-2. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, a little surprising you wouldn't pull the trigger on that one right there. This isn't anything fancy. Just a right over the top four-seam fastball, absolutely frozen.
Here's Michael Morse now. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing in one.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of.
Now here's the pitch. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Some would say he's showing good patience here, waiting for his pitch. But as a number five hitter, I think you need to make something happen.
And now a pitch on the way. Swing and a hot shot towards the hole. He's got it well into right field. Throw gets him there from short right field. A nice play, and that one ends the inning. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. Three innings complete. It's the Marlins 2. And the Orioles nothing. David Lowe will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
The left fielder, number 9, David Lowe.
Now here it comes. And a cut fastball, but this bounces near the plate for a ball. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here comes the 1-1. Now that's popped up. Room behind the plate for Salto Lamacchia. And he will make the catch here right in front of the screen, and that's your first out. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. Manny Machado will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Now the first pitch. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
And we've seen a lot of that pitch here in the first four innings, and it's been real effective for him, and that's another example right there.
Machado now on 0-1. And that's a called strike at the letters. Though that looked high from here, it's 0-2 now.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, most of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
Too high. 1-2. Here comes the 1-2. Caught off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Here it comes. Here's a fly ball now, lifted in the air out to right. He'll take this in without much trouble, and two are gone here to start the fourth.
Boy, and he's come out with a plan against these hitters, and he's executed that plan to perfection here early on. That's seven in a row now he's set down.
Adam Jones will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
First pitch coming. A bit high there. A ball and no strikes.
Looks like a ball to me.
Now the 1-0 pitch. That missed. Close. It's ball two.
And on 2-0, this is where he's the most dangerous up there. I know it's a fastball count, but I would maybe think about something else.
Here's the 2-0 pitch now to Jones. 3-0 now.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. The 3-1 coming. Fouled back. Three-two pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. No runs, just one hit, and no errors for the Orioles so far. A payoff pitch one more time. Swing and a hard hit grounder down the line. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but it gets by the glove down the line.
Well, he'd had some high-stress innings here so far. It was looking like he turned a corner and was on his way to a much-needed 1-2-3, but he's going to have to get in the stretch here after all.
Steve Pierce will stand in. A base hit his first time around. Here's the first offering. Down and away, one ball and no strikes.
But now you got to regroup after the two-out single. You're in a dangerous spot in the lineup, so the inning's not over yet, not by a long shot.
Here's the 1-0. Runner goes for second. Pitches a cold strike. The throw. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Nothing doing this time around for the O's. They're down 2-0. Martin Prado will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. First offering on the way. The cutter runs outside, ball one. The 1-0 home. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Well, he's been in a tough stretch offensively, and this sure ain't gonna help.
The 1-1. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. Here comes the 2-1. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Here's the 2-2 home. This is hit to the right side and in the right field. It's a 2-for-2 start for him tonight, a base hit. Jared Saltalamacchia will stand in. He reached on a fielder's choice his first time. Now here's the first pitch. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. He's ready. Now the pitch. That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count. Nobody out, runner on first. From the stretch. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. So after getting the strikeout on the fastball, not a bad time to check out our pitch speed comparison for our two starters. And both of these guys bringing it pretty good. 97 and 93 is the top recorded speed so far. Donovan Solano will dig in. He singled his first time around. First pitch coming. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. For second, pitches a cold strike. The throw, it's high, but a fine play to come down with it at second, and he's out trying to steal a base.
Well, they're going to be fairly lucky to still throw this guy out right here. We'll take a look at it. It's a fastball, but the throw down is a high one, and this is where guys can get hurt all the time. But he goes up, gets the baseball, and then slaps the tag down right on him.
Here's the 1-1. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Here's Tillman on 2-1. Cut fastball that time, but he doesn't bite, and now it's 3-1.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
The 3-1. And look out. That's in very tight, and it's ball four.
That's a good job right there with two away, because if nothing else, you get your pitcher to the plate here in this inning, so you don't force him to lead off your next inning offensively.
Jared Cozart will try it again. Set down on strikes his first time. Now the first pitch. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. The next pitch. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. We'll reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. One left for Miami. They're up 2-0. Steve Pierce will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Steve Pierce.
Strike him out.
And here's the first pitch. And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
Swing and a bouncer out in front. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. So another exceptional effort for him on the mound. He's got the shutout working here, as we'll show you the league ERA leaders. And as you can see there, he in fact leads the NL in that category. Caleb Joseph will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. First pitch coming. Cut fastball in there for a called strike.
Well, you get the sense that what they need is one big hit from anybody in the lineup. If they could get one, it could get them right back in this game, because right now they just seem out of it.
Now the pitch. Swing and a ball pretty well hit out towards left center. And this is handled easily, so quickly two are gone here to start the fifth. So still nothing against him on the scoreboard here in the fifth as we check out the league leaderboard for team ERA. And as you see there, they're currently tied for third in that department. Ryan Flaherty will dig in, 0 for 1 here in this one. First pitch to him. And a bouncing ball, foul. Pitch on the way. Now he's able to go with the pitch here as this is hit toward the hole and through it for a two-out single. And now he has some trouble with it in left.
And they're able to keep the inning alive as you check out the numbers on his performance so far. That's just the third hit he's allowed to this point. He's been pretty much in control the whole way.
Jonathan Scope will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Now here's the first pitch. Too low, 1-0. No runs, three hits, and no errors for the Orioles so far. Here comes the 1-0. Here's a swing and a ground ball hits a Prado at third. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. One left for the Orioles. They trail it here 2-0. D. Gordon will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Here's the first offering. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. And the pitch. Now the 0-1 is lifted in the air out to left field. Lowe has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one. Christian Yelich will stand in. He's 1 for 2 so far. Here's the first pitch to him. First pitch is a cutter looked at, 0-1.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
The pitch. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. And now a pitch on the way. Swing and a ball headed towards the hole. Throw gets him, 2 down. Giancarlo Stanton will stand in. He drove in a run with a sac fly his last time. First pitch on the way. Here's a cold strike about thigh high. Nothing and one. Now the pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. Joseph is in his tracks now, and he will put it away to retire the side. Miami down in order as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. J.P. Arencibia will stand in here to get things started in the Baltimore sixth. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. And, oh, look out, as the cutter ran way in and just about drilled him. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
Good tailing action there. It's 1-1.
Well, it's just game one of this series, but you almost have to wonder if they forgot to pack their offense when they got on the plane. It's been nowhere to be found so far.
Ready now on 1-1. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
And all through this winning streak of theirs, we've seen some great starting pitching, and this has been another very good performance. Good enough to most likely keep that winning streak going.
Chris Tillman will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First pitch coming. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Here's the 1-0. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. The 1-1. And he throws a cutter right by him to take control, 1-2. For that man right there, you need look back only to his last start to see a performance like the one he's shown here so far.
And well on his way to another great outing. And that's what you get when you mix your speeds and throw a lot of strikes.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Well, I don't know if that was just discipline or whether he just wasn't going to swing the bat at all. At least he's making him throw a few pitches.
The 2-2. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down.
But this is one of those situations where his guys got him the lead early on, and he's been in complete control ever since. I mean, he's barely been threatened out there.
David Lowe will dig in. 0 for 2. He's flied out and popped out so far. Here's the first offering. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0.
Still a little bit early to be worrying about this, but in a two-run game, a two-out walk here would at least get the tying run to the plate. And on top of that, this guy has some pop.
Bases are empty here with two men out. The 1-0 pitch. Yeehaw! And a strike to even the count, 1-1.
And that has been the comfort zone so far in this outing. He's just lived on that outside corner, and it's paid big dividends for him.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Two out, nobody on. The 2-1. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. And with the tying run in the on-deck circle, the question, does he take a look at another one here?
He just might. You're still going to see a good pitch on 3-2, even if this one's a strike.
Now the 3-1. And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
Well, two-way, you're just looking to get on base somehow, especially when this guy hasn't given you anything so far. So, at the very least, make him work out of the stretch and throw a few more pitches here.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and standing in now the third baseman, Manny Machado. Now the first pitch. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Pause, now the pitch. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. A runner on first with two away. Here's the 1-1. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Now the 1-2. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2.
Yeah, that was outside, but it's right where he wants that pitch to be. If you do take that thing, there's no guarantee that it won't be called strike three.
The 2-2 coming. Fouled off into the seats behind first. The 2-2 one more time. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
And now 3-2, two out. He'll be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
Three-two, here it comes. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Payoff pitch coming. And he may be starting to lose the feel here as that misses for ball four, and that's back-to-back walks now with two away.
First and second now after the walk, and they haven't gotten much going offensively against this guy at all. So this is about as good an opportunity as they've had.
Adam Jones will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
Come on, hold them down!
First offering on the way. Ball one.
Sooner or later, the Orioles are going to have to find that key hit. Pretty much eluded them all throughout.
Two men are on with two men out. The 1-0. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. The 1-1 now to Jones. Big breaking ball and a beauty that time. 1-2.
A strike away now from getting through 6 shutout innings here, and that's no small feat against this lineup.
The 1-2. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Now another 1-2. Breaking ball there is down. Good job of laying off. It's back to 2-2.
That's a good idea, 1-2 right there, just to see if he'd chase. But now with the count even, I think this one has to be in the strike zone because you don't want to run the risk of loading the bases for the cleanup guy.
The 2-2 coming now to Jones. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. Here comes the 2-2. Now a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Another 2-2. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2. And now the runners will get a head start here with two away.
And that's an important factor, too, because that's the tying run over there at first base. So he's likely scoring on an extra base hit.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Fouled back. Once again, a 3-2. Now a pitch swung on and hit to the left side, but this is going to find the seats, a foul ball. Here's the full count offering, and this is fouled back and out of play. The next 3-2. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Marcelo Zuna will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Now here's the first pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground, but a foul ball here, 0-1. Now here it comes. Swing and a ball pulled foul into the lower level and left. Now the pitch. And a cut fastball, but this bounces near the plate for a ball. Here comes a 1-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Well, he is definitely doing his part out there. You see his line so far. He's keeping his guys in the ball game. He's just not getting any help offensively.
Michael Morse will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. First pitch coming. Here's a knuckle curve that backs him up a bit. Ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's a 1-0. Went about halfway there, but it's a called strike regardless. The 1-1 home. Right down the chute that time, 1-2.
Hard to believe he'd let that one go. That was right on a platter for him.
Let's go, wait for the pitch. One out, nobody on. The 1-2 with one away. To two balls and two strikes now.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
Here he comes on 2-2. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Here's the 2-2 offering. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. Bases are empty, one man out. 3-2, here it is. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. You gave him a pretty good battle up there, and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
And now here comes Oriole manager Buck Showalter on his way to the mound. And he'll motion for the bullpen here, so that's going to be all for Chris Tillman. So he'll depart after 5 1/3 innings of work and with no shot to win the decision. Tommy Hunter will come on now as he inherits a runner at first with already one out in the inning.
Tommy Hunter.
Martin Prado will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And here's the first pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Runners on first with one down. Comes set, now the pitch. On its tailor-made to short, 6-4-3. It's a double play and the inning is over. Nothing doing for the Marlins. but they're on top 2-0. Welcome back to South Florida. It's on to the seventh inning with the Marlins on top, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first six innings of play. Steve Pierce will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. Now the first pitch. And the first pitch of the inning here is promptly laced into center field for a leadoff single.
One of the first times tonight that they've had their leadoff man on base. Now they've got to find a way to build on it if they want to get back in this thing.
Caleb Joseph will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out 0-for-2 thus far. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. First pitch coming. And a ball 1-0. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. On the way. And that's in there for his strike 1-1.
Yeah, and it seems like he kind of got away from that pitch here in the last few innings. You got to think about bringing that one right back.
A runner at first with no outs here. Now the 1-1 pitch. Called strike 2 on the cutter, and he's behind in the count now, 1-2.
Boy, it's one thing for a reliever to come in out of the pen and throw 100 miles an hour for 15 pitches or so. But he's right up there around the century mark now, and he's still throwing hard.
Here's the 1-2. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Nobody out, runner on first. Here's another 1-2. Oh, on the ground to first. Can this be two? Solano for one. On to first. A double play.
Boy, and that's good athleticism here by the pitcher getting off the mound. He gets the ground ball to first, but then he hustles his way over to the bag to help them wrap up that 3-6-1 double play.
Into the box now, Ryan Flaherty. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Bases are empty here with two men out. The 1-0. A high strike there, and it's 1-1. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Big breaking ball and a beauty. 1-2. Next pitch will be number 100 for him now through 6 2/3. And he takes very close to the inside corner here. 2-2 though.
I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
I tried to bury one down and away, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
Oh, the crowd thought they had him, but definitely outside. Not by a whole lot, though.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And this will be fouled away. Full count pitch on its way. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. 3-2 pitch. And the payoff pitch is chopped foul at home plate, so we'll do it again. Still 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Swing and a ball hit well to the right side, but this will get into the crowd. The 3-2 one more time. And he misses ball four.
Guys, that's just an amazing at-bat right there. All that guy on the mound wants to do is find that one put-away pitch and get him back in the dugout. But try as he might, he never could find it. And he winds up not only losing this guy, but taking up a big chunk of his stamina to do it.
Well, now the Miami manager's up out of the dugout and on his way out to the mound. And it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. So as he departs, he'll remain responsible for the man left to board, but he cannot lose this one. Jared Burton will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh.
Jared Burton.
Jonathan Schoop will stand in now in what could be a real make or break situation.
And you think at this point you have to get something out of this inning. The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
Now here's the first pitch. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. That's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
From the belt, the pitch. One and
nope,
one.
That's outside. Ball. Wrong.
Now the 1-1. And they'll come inside with this one, but the result's the same. It's the 2-1 now. Here's the 2-1 pitch. 3-1 now. And I think he wanted to know where that one was.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
The 3-1 pitch. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Two out with the man at first. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Hard hit towards center. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Orioles leave one. They trail things here 2-0. Jared Saltalamacchia will dig in now, hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here's the first offering. Bottom three in the batting order here as the first pitch misses to the number seven hitter. It's ball one. Now the 1-0. And oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
Tonight, borderline calls, you got to be swinging.
1-1 pitch on the way. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. The 2-1 home. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. Under it is Machado, and he'll take it for the first out.
Here's that swing again. This is in show motion. And, you'll see that that's a few inches above the thumbs. You'll be feeling that one all night long.
In now, Donovan Solano. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. One out, nobody on. 1-0 pitch now. Swing and a shot toward right center, and he'll have himself a base hit.
This is something their hitting coach preaches every day at the batting cage. Stay inside the ball. Here, he lets the ball get deeper into the zone, then stays back and drives it to the right center gap.
Ichiro Suzuki will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Pierce is over near the line now as he makes the catch for the second out of the inning.
The batter, number 9, second baseman, Dee Gordon.
Dee Gordon will get another shot now, 2-for-3 in the game. First pitch to him. A fastball here as you'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. A runner on first with two away. Now the 1-0 pitch. Breaking balls in there that time, 1-1.
Yeah, and it's tough enough to hit 95 plus mile an hour fastballs. That curve gives you something else to think about altogether.
1-1 on the way. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Two out with the man at first. Now the 1-2 home to Gordon. Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed, so he'll need to get the force at first. And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, score at 2-3, and the inning is over. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. It's the Marlins 2 and the Orioles nothing. A.J. Ramos will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8.
A.J. Ramos.
J.Pierre Encibia will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Ooh, started him with the change, and it's nothing in one. Here's the pitch. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. The 1-1. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
And you can see him shaking his head out there. I think he felt that one was a little bit low. And you know what? He may have had a case.
Right-hander deals on 1-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. With that, we'll give you a look at our starter comparison for the two starting pitchers in the game. And the column to look at is the one on the right side of your screen. Not too many hits to go around at this point in the ballgame. Chris Davis will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. And that's in there for strike one. Pitch on the way. And low, it's a ball and a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's the 1-1. This is past the mound and into center field for a base hit.
He
Yeah, really not a bad pitch when you look at it. This is at the knees with some movement. He just uses the center of the diamond and checks in here with a base hit.
David Lowe will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
Here's the first pitch to him. Line fouled off to the left and a few rows back. He's ready now, the pitch. And there's ball one. Now, how important is it going to be for this guy to throw that curveball for strikes?
I don't know that he necessarily needs to ever throw it for a strike. I mean, if it's around the plate and he's getting guys to go after it, it's doing its job. But if he starts to get too high or too far outside, then it's just an easy take.
Runner at first here, one man out. Here comes the 1-2. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. He'll try again, 1-2. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Very brisk pace to the ball game thus far. 2-0 our score as you get a look there at the line score to this point in the contest. Manny Machado will stand in, 0-2 thus far. First pitch coming. And looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's 0-1. Machado now on 0-1. And oh, that looked to catch him flush down near the foot or the ankle. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. Home half of the eighth, straight ahead. The Marlins lead this one 2-0. Ryan Webb is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
Ryan Webb.
Christian Yelich will get us started here for Miami, and he'll have backup in the form of Giancarlo Stanton waiting on deck. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Fastball in there for a called strike. The pitch. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at one. Ready now on 1-1. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now.
Let's go, guys.
Ready with the 2-1. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. Sets the 2-2 pitch. Hit hard to the right side, but right to him out at second. Well, he got a lot of that ball, but nothing to show for it to start the home eighth.
Yeah, and late in a close game like this, that would have been a good leadoff base runner to have. And he definitely hits this ball hard. It's just pretty much right at the glove.
Giancarlo Stanton now. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. One-oh. Fastball at 94 miles an hour, and it's 1-1.
Yeah, showing no fear there. He put the pitch right at the letters away, but that guy didn't want any part of it.
Here comes the 1-1. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
And that's exactly where you want to put that thing. Start it right down the middle and trust that its action will cause it to drop.
Now the 1-2. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. 1 out, nobody on. 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now. What's the call here?
I still don't think I throw him a strike. There's a good chance that he's going to be chasing something, expand the zone, so you make him show you that he can hold back.
Now the payoff pitch home. No offer from Stanton. It's ball four, so he'll head down to first. Marcell Ozuna will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot. 0-3 thus far. Here's the first offering. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one. The 1-0 home. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. The 1-1. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
And this has been his problem all night long. Just keeps going after pitches that he should be watching.
Runners on first with one down. The 1-2. And he struck him out. And there's the hat trick, as that's his third strikeout of the ball game.
We showed you his numbers a minute ago. It's still early in the season to be worrying too much, but he's definitely off to a slow start. So he's going to need to string together a few good outings to lower that ERA a little bit.
Michael Morse will step in now, 0-2 to this point. First pitch on the way. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. He's set. Now the pitch. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
1-1.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
Let's go, Michael.
A runner on first with two away. Here comes a 1-2. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Marlins leave one, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Adam Jones will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth as they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
And whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
Here we go with inning number nine as the first pitch misses for ball one.
Well, you know, if there's anybody in this lineup capable of getting a rally started, this is the guy right here.
1-0 on the way. Sinker stays outside and is behind now 2-0.
You got to think one thing here. Get on base. A walk will do the trick.
Two-oh count, the pitch, and a drive out to deep right center field. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. The relay, but he is in there with a triple.
You've got one goal here in the ninth. That's get the tying run to the plate. And he just whacks this ball. A single might have done the same thing, and I think he took a little bit of a chance at he didn't need to take, but he does make it into third with a triple.
Here's Steve Pierce now as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. Figure we'll probably see a heavy dose of that sinker here tonight.
It's really a pitch you'll lean on, especially when he needs that ground ball, but even in situations like this where he's just trying to get ahead.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Sinker, one ball, one strike.
That's a pitch you really have to learn to take against a guy like this. But even if you make contact, you're just going to get something in on the label, so that's a great take.
The 1-1 home. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Nervous time now in that third base dugout.
Heck, nervous time up here. My heart's racing, and I'm just watching this game.
Now the 2-1. Pitches away, but it's swung on and grounded to second. Throw on to first to be in time, but meanwhile the lead shrinks to one here on the RBI ground ball.
Well, they're able to draw one run closer. That's the good news. But from a defensive perspective, they're just happy to get that man out at first and ring up the first out of the ninth inning.
Into the box, Caleb Joseph. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Bases are empty, one man out. The next pitch. Hard hit down the line. And he'll take this on to first, and they're down to their final out, two away. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play. And as you see there, he's sitting in second place in the National League in that department. Ryan Flaherty will stand in. Base on balls his last time. Now the first pitch. And they'll try and get him out in front to start the at-bat, but this misses off the plate away. It's ball one. Here's the 1-0. Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. Two out, nobody on. Here's the 1-1. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
They're definitely making him work out there. He came in trying to shut the door, and he has not had an easy time of it.
Two-one. Now an off-speed pitch well inside, and it forces him to bounce away from danger.
Sometimes if you let that changeup go too soon, it'll take off on you. He's lucky that didn't hit him.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Here he comes on 3-1. Now a swing and a sharp ground ball to third. Up with it now is Pato. Well, the first is going to be in time to take care of him, and the Marlins make it six straight victories now as this one is over.
Well, here we go. Tack another one onto that winning streak. They've now got it up to six in a row, and it's not looking like this hot spell is going to end anytime soon. Thank you.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he needed just a little help to get out of that seventh inning, but all in all, that's 6 2/3, very strong innings for him on the mound.
So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, follow us on Twitter at MLB The Show. The Marlins win it 2-1. Good night from Miami.